Peter's father was on deathbed. He wanted to talk to Peter, to explain something to Peter, because Peter was going very much astray. He was after all the girls who were in the village. He was after all. He was chasing them. Father told Peter, "Peter, it's my lifelong experience. What I am telling you, in village, you go on chasing girls, you go on looking for them, you after every girl you go, you have become Don Juan. It's my experience and I am concluding it. I have known it myself. Now when I am dying, I am telling you. Beauty is only skin deep. It's only appearance. Think. It's only skin deep. It is only appearance. Don't waste your time like that. What you are seeing, what you are seeking, what you are searching. Chasing all the women of the town, running behind the beauty. It's my lifelong experience. I have also chased women, but on my deathbed, I am going to tell you something very important, and this is my lifelong experience, that beauty is skin deep. Peter thought for a while and replied to his father, "Father, that is enough for me. I am not a cannibal. I am not going to eat a woman. Skin deep is enough for me. Who wants the inside of woman? You see, the misunderstanding goes on. Whatever you say, the other can understand according to his conditioning defects, even with the name. If you have seen the military people, whole life they do attention. And if a military man goes, if you say attention, even though he is retired, he will be in attention. Some time ago I was seeing a film about a military man. Military men are very particular. And I was seeing in the film that a military man was passing near a sea beach and a man was shouting, "Help! Help! Shark! Help!" The man was looking. The military man was looking this whole situation. People gathered and they seeing that, two, three women told, "Can't you help him?" He told, "Well, I am myself puzzled. This man is asking help from shark. How can I help?" He says, "Help, shark, help." And that's fact. if no one asks you? It's not your matter sometimes. You run away. Society has created military. It is very difficult to come out of that military conditioning. And whatever is taught, whatever you understand with the name of meditation, you understand that according to your conditioning. There was one Zen monastery, and in that monastery there was a strange rule. There were some rooms, and only the monks who could defeat the monks living there could live in that houses. Who knew more about Buddhism, who knew more about spirituality, a spiritual debate. There always had been debate whenever some stranger was there. If anybody was defeated, had to leave the monastery. There were two brothers living together in that monastery. They were very well known. One of them was very brilliant. He knew all the teachings of Lord Buddha. And the one he had head and one eye, but somehow brain was missing. Very aggressive and less intelligent. But they somehow managed to be together. One day a wandering monk came there. He was just wandering in that area and he entered that place. The elder brother, who was intelligent, that day he had already a debate, so he asked his younger brother, knowing that this is difficult, so he told, you have to debate in silence. Don't use word, debate in silence. They were sat in a room. They were sitting in a room, facing each other. Suddenly this stranger monk showed him one finger up. Seeing this, the brother of the intelligent gentleman with the one eye, he raised two fingers. Seeing that, the stranger monk raised three fingers. Suddenly, that one-eyed man clenched his fist. And marked on the face of that stranger man. He gave him a boxing. Middle of the nose. The meeting was over and that man was going. Suddenly he found that one eye man's elder brother, who was intelligent. He told him, well, your brother is awesome, he is super intelligent. He defeated me, and as I am defeated, now I am going to leave the monastery. He could not understand. He told, explain me what happened. The man told, well, actually, after sitting face to face to each other, I raised my one finger indicating in the world only Buddha's teachings are essential. Only one Buddha's teachings are essential. Then your brother raised two fingers. He meant not Buddha's teaching, Buddha's teaching and his scripture. I was amazed with this answer. Then I raised my three fingers, showing and indicating Buddha's teaching, Buddha himself, and disciple of Buddha. Then he clenched his fist and gave me a punch on face. And I understood he is right. They all are one. He left the monastery. Suddenly a younger brother, the one-eyed boy, appeared there. And he was asking, he ran into the brother and told, where is that stupid monk? I want to beat him. He told, explain me the matter. What happened? He told, well, we were sitting quietly. Suddenly he raised one finger, indicating and offending me that you have only one eye. But I wanted to be kind. I wanted to show him humility. I showed him two fingers, congratulating, you have two eyes. But then again, he was so mean, he showed three, indicating that between us we have three eyes. Now this was enough, it was a great insult for me, so I punched him. So you see, if you want to understand, you can understand from everywhere, even from that stupid one-eyed blind man. The monk understood. Everywhere there is teaching. If you are ready to learn to understand, the understanding will come into you.